Hello and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Cardboard Coat Check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, what I want to do today for you is let you know what you get in the box with this. This is MLEM. MLEM Space Agency. This is a game from Rebel Studios out of Poland. And what actually has me excited, like Cats in Space, yes, one of the reasons I have this game. I got to thank, I'll call it out right now, I got to thank Rebel Studios for sending a review copy of this. But one of the reasons I agreed to review this game is because I have two daughters that both love cats and one daughter who loves sci-fi and space. So like one daughter I got cats, boom. The other daughter, cats and space. She's so excited. She saw this and she went and grabbed her sister and was like, look what dad has. Well, this is MLEM Space Agency. What I'm excited about, though, is this is the latest game from Reiner Knizia, a famed game designer that has hundreds of games under their belt, who I love a lot of, one of the favorites being Lost Cities. That was one of the games that got me into hobby gaming. But anyway, we're here to look at MLEM. First step, though, cut the shrink, then I'll show you what's inside the box. All right, here we go. Shrink's off. You can get to see here's the cover of MLEM. MLEM Space Agency, a little bit of UV spotting, which I couldn't tell through the shrink wrap on the gold here. Can't see it. It's a little reflective. We'll show off the sides quick here. Not a lot to see on the sides, though they did do the awesome thing. If you store your games this way, you're good. If you store your games this way, you're good. I always appreciate that. I will show off the box back so you can kind of see what's going on. This is a dice placement game. And it's supposed to have a mat, which I'm really looking forward to that. Board games coming with mats is something I would love to see more of. Please give it to me. And the lid doesn't want to let go of the box. Come on. It's coming there. Woof. Step one, MLEM, get the box open. All right. We're going to quickly flip through the rule book here. There is a QR code if you prefer to watch, which I totally understand. Oh, nice. That is a really nice component overview. Thank you for that. Shows you how to set up, then how to play, goal of the game, takeoff phase, travel phase, landing phase, counting points, disembarking, we're launching our cats to planets, functions of the astronauts, and advanced game variants. We're looking at 12 pages. That's after things like the, counters and stuff. So we actually start on page 4. So like 8 pages of rules, counting setup, and then some advanced variants. Always appreciated. Secret missions. We got the credits here on the back and an icon explanation. Thank you. That is always good to see. Thank you, Rebel Studio. Oh, look at that. That's just striking. I think that's striking. These look like they're awards in gold, silver, bronze, some tokens, a ship, a rocket ship. Oh, everything punches nice and easy. Nice thick cardboard. Good quality. Get to see the other sides of these tokens in the ship. Lots of counters. Lots of little cat-shaped counters. Lots of cardboard. This is why we tend to call our board games cardboard. Okay, the back of the cat tokens are just too cute. My daughter's going to go bonkers over that. Some UFOs. Okay, these appear to be in player colors. So you have the green player colors, the pink player colors, the blue, the yellow. Yes, there's yellow. Yes, I play yellow. Some different rocket ships. There's a lot of counters in this game. Some of these obviously are going to have hidden information. I have not played this game. I was completely sold by Knizia and my kids were completely sold by Cats in Space. So, wow, that's a lot of cardboard. Look at that. That is a stack of stuff to punch out. All right, trough insert. Not a huge fan of trough inserts. Okay, it's weird that this is here. Like, yeah, you actually have like a box to put stuff in. All right, never mind. The insert's a little better than I thought it was going to be. D6 dice that aren't quite D6 dice. They look like D6 dice. But there's a 1. There's a 2. Oh, there's another 2. There's a 3. There's a 4. There's a rocket. So 1, 2, 2, 3, 4. Comet, I should say. Not a rocket. Comet. So custom D6s. They look a lot like they just have standard pips, but they're not. These are silkscreened, not actually etched or anything in there. There's no divots for the pips. We have 2 unique looking wooden silkscreened again, which is nice. Nice touch. White silk screening over green and purple. There's a UFO and a spaceship. So obviously some type of trackers. Nice component there. Light, very light. You can kind of see the thickness and, well, the UFO shaped saucer, I should say. And probably both UFOs. Extra baggies, always appreciated, especially when I see that many tokens in a game. This looks good. Not folded. So extra baggies, player boards. Those are obviously where those cat tokens go. I will point this out, slight disappointment, a little bit of warpage there. So these boards are going to have to, it's like two of them. Oddly, two of the boards have a little bit of warpage, so we're going to have to put those under something heavy for a little while. Single-sided boards. And the five different player colors with unique cat artwork on each. Cats in space. I'd personally like the chonky cat with the spatula, but it's not yellow, though. I might have to play gray or black in this game. Is that? That's just part of the box. Okay, that's cool. There's like the spaceship viewport in the box insert here. And then, yeah, this is fantastic. Instead of a board, there is a neoprene mat here. Still sealed in shrink. Nice and rolled up. I'm scared to open it because I'll never get it closed again and back into the box. But we're going to crack this open. Was not resealable. So now you can see, oh, it's definitely not going to fit on my camera. But we have a path with all kinds of, there's a planet made of yarn. That's awesome. Sorry, the theming in this is just really cool. Okay, what I'm going to do is just kind of drag this across. It's a Knizia game. I'm assuming it's going to have some math and some pusher luck. And there's a track down at the bottom. That is one nice board. Now, just to kind of show it off this way. Can you see it all? There, you can at least see how long this board is. See how long this board is? That is a long board. Did I do it? Did I do it? Yes. Sweet. I managed to get it to fit. All right. Looks great. Production quality here is fantastic. I'm excited by what I'm seeing here, which is always good. That neoprene mat is fantastic. Custom dice, some baggies for all these tokens. And I got a lot to punch. Pro tip, once you punch all these, lift this cardboard box insert out and put it underneath. That'll make this flush with the top of the box and hold things in place a lot better, especially if you like to store your games vertically instead of horizontally. So there you have. Oh, I have that one that punched out. I'm going to have to put that in the bottom. There we go. What you get with MLEM Space Agency. All right, there you have what you get in the box for MLEM Space Agency, Cats in Space by Reiner Knizia. Really looking forward to checking this one out. Extremely impressed by the component quality here. Rebel Studios makes some great games, so we have reviewed some in the past. Feel free to check it out. One of our favorites being Chronicles of Avel. I'll be sure to toss a link to that review so you can check that one out. That is a cooperative tower defense style game. This is something completely different. This is a competitive game where you're choosing a cat astronaut and rolling dice and choosing how far to move your ship, how far to move the ship, and you're trying to land on planets and try to collect things. It looks really cool. But what blew me away, though, is that neoprene mat. That neoprene mat is nice. It's even stitched on the edges. It's not like a mouse pad that's loose. I don't see any worry about fraying. Super thick player boards. Single layer. They weren't dual layer boards or anything cool like that. But the single layer boards, really evocative artwork. And I love like the rocket ship for determining player order. Yeah, it just looks really cool. Looking forward to checking this one out. My girls really want to get this game to the table. So we're probably going to get this one to the table sooner rather than later. And when we do, I'll be sharing my thoughts on social media where I can be found everywhere as Tabletop Bellhop, one word. And on the blog at tabletopbellhop.com. As well as the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. Thank you very much for joining me for this MLEM Space Agency. I hate saying the word MLEM. I'm too old for MLEM. Yeah. Good day and game on.